As someone who always has 1,000 tabs open, I find it overwhelming to even navigate and find one specific tab out of the 1,000 that I have open every single time. This is a common issue, and I'm sure a lot of you can relate with it as well. This meme on the internet perfectly captures the exact feeling I feel every time I figure out a fix to my bug, for example, and have to close the 1,000 other tabs that I have open. But jokes aside, managing your tabs can become an extreme sport, especially if you're like me and you like to hoard your tabs just because you feel that you might need them later. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing one of my recent internet finds that I've been sleeping on. As you can already tell from the title, it's a browser. Let's dive into why I'm excited about it. I've been using Chrome as my default browser for the longest time. Even when Brave became popular, I would use both of them simultaneously. But I always went back to Chrome. However, that has changed since I discovered SigmaOS browser. SigmaOS is a new browser that helps you stay organized and focused when using the internet. If you're someone who is constantly struggling with having too many tabs open, SigmaOS could be the right solution you've been looking for. It offers features like workspaces, pages, focus mode, split screen that makes it a seamless browser to work with. It also has a unique user interface, which is one of the features that I really like about it, that allows you to manage your tabs efficiently and also stay on top of important tasks. I think the best thing was how easy it was to move from Chrome to Sigma. All I needed to do was install the application, and then I followed the steps outlined for me to migrate my bookmarks history from Chrome over to SigmaOS. I really liked the onboarding flow. It made me quite excited that I could choose different workspaces based on my interests. Workspaces are a way to manage your pages or web pages by project, allowing you to group and manage tabs according to the tasks or projects that you're working on. You also have pages, which are your typical web pages that you can either use the search to find or navigate to it using a URL. Another thing that I found interesting was the concept of lazy search. It's typically a search bar, but in this case, it's hidden using just the search icon, and you can navigate to it by either going directly to click on the search icon and enter the URL you're trying to navigate to, or search for pages if that's what you're trying to do, or use a shortcut to find new pages. Another nice feature I found interesting is the focus mode. Now, as you're working on SigmaOS, you might find the sidebars are a little bit distracting while you're working, so you can also turn that on or off based on your preference. So right now, if I'm trying to be fully focused on something that I'm looking at, I like to turn it off so that I really focus and I'm not looking to switch tabs or just navigate somewhere else. So I use the shortcut F to navigate to the focus mode, or just click the button on the top side of the page to turn on focus mode. I really like this feature a lot because it gives me this zen feeling that, oh, I'm really into, you know, my zen mode to start working, so I don't need any distractions at any point in time while I'm in this mode. Does that make any sense? Yeah. Then there's a split screen. This is another interesting feature. It kind of gives me VS Code type of vibe, which I really like. It allows you to open two pages side by side, allowing you to multitask. So here, if you're trying to, for example, work on a document while you're researching resources for that document, you can have on one side the docs that you're working on and the other side a different tab where you're taking information from. So I find it very interesting and also highly productive, because then you are not switching between tabs. You just have to look at one page and you have the information that you're looking for. Really interesting feature. Another thing that I noticed using this browser is that most of the shortcuts are single shortcut keys. This is really nice because it allows you to remember all the shortcuts, which is something that personally I struggle with when using applications that have multi multiple shortcut keys like Control Shift and a key, or Control Alt and a key, right? But here in Sigma, most of the shortcuts are single keys. Like if you're trying to turn on the focus mode, you just need to click F. If you're trying to like open a new browser, I think the shortcut for that is N. So most of them are single keys, and there is also a cheat sheet in case you forget any of the shortcuts that you can also open with the shortcut C. I find this really productive because it's easy for you to, you know, do things without having to find where they are or click multiple screens or keys to get information or get what you're trying to do. Another way to navigate through the browser is by using the VS Code style command palette, which I kind of find interesting that most applications are currently using. Like Obsidian, for example, has something similar, but I really like that this is in the browser. By just hitting command K, I can use the command palette to literally search for anything, from opening the inspector to opening a new browser, opening a new tab, or creating a new workspace. Like, the possibilities you can get directly from just hitting command K is endless, making your workflow seamless and making it easy for you to find things. I know you're saying, yes, Gift, this is nice, but what about inspector and extensions? Don't worry, I had the same question too. SigmaOS allow you use extensions. In fact, it's the first WebKit browser to power Chrome extensions. You can access your extensions or download new ones by using the shortcut E. Pretty seamless, right? And for the inspector, I know as a developer, you might be interested in inspecting the network tab or even downloading like dev tools so you can directly inspect your applications as you're working on them in the browser. Don't worry, all of this is possible because you can also access the inspector directly by using command shift I. I think this is the same shortcut on Chrome, so there is literally no difference for you if you're coming from Chrome, for example. So all of this is still possible for you to do with this browser. SigmaOS browsers offers you an intuitive user interface, a better way for you to manage your tabs, and a productive environment for you to do your best work. If you're interested in trying it out, you can use the link displayed on the screen or the link in the description to get started. Everyone gets a 14-day free trial to try out the pro subscription, and after that you can either decide to pay for it or switch to the free option, which for me the difference is you only have access to one workspace as opposed to having multiple workspaces to work with. The good news is if you're a student or an academic, you can apply to get 50% off the pro subscription by using the form also in the description. So make use of that opportunity if you're a student or an academic. Let me know your thoughts in the comments after trying it out. Do you like this browser? Do you find that you can switch from Chrome over to this browser? I'm very interested in hearing what you all think. Thank you all so much for watching this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. I look forward to making more videos for you all. If you'd like to watch a video of how I set up my MacBook Pro 14-inch, then check out this video. And if you'd like to see the 5 productivity tools that I recommend for developers, then watch this video. Thank you so much, and I'll see you in my next one.